Hello and welcome to My Secret Math Tutor. In this video, we'll be making a line chart using the Ti-89 graphing calculator. Now, for the example, I've already gone through in a different video on how to make a line chart by hand, but we'll use the same data so we can compare what the calculator is giving us with what we actually did when we were doing these, individually. In this example, we were keeping track of how many students were enrolled in a particular school for a given year. So let's go ahead and grab those graphing calculators and see how we can get all of that information in there. All right, so the first part of this is we need to take the raw data and put it into our calculators. I'm on the home screen right now, but go ahead and press your app button so we can find our data matrix editor. Okay, looks like it's right there on my calculator. I'm going to select it and press enter. Let's go ahead and select a new data matrix. So we'll go down to 3 for new. And now we get to choose where we want to store it and what we want to call it. I like to leave mine just in the main folder, but you can set up other folders. As for the variable, that's what you want to call it. And you can pretty much call it anything as long as it's not reserved. Since I'm talking about students here, I'm going to call it S for students. So my entire table will just be called S in the calculator. All right, everything looks good. Now press enter twice. All right, so now we're actually in the data matrix editor. We'll put all of our information into both of these columns. Let's start off with the year. So 1990, enter, 1992, and all the way down the line. All right, perfect. We have all of our years in there. Now let's go ahead in the next column and put how many students we have enrolled for each of these years. So I need to go all the way back near the top here. There we are. So 1,103, and of course, all the way down. All right, perfect. Looks like everything is paired up in here, so I didn't miss any of my data values. Now, it's also important that you arrange these from smallest to largest, because it's going to start connecting the first one to the second one to the third one, when it gets to making that line chart. If you end up just scattering all of these data values in your table, then your lines will be scattered as well. It'll connect however it is organized in this table. All right, so everything looks good. Let's get into our plot setup so we can tell it that we want a line chart. So, and that's under F2 where it says plot setup. Go ahead and press that. And we want to define a new one, so press F1. All right, our very first option is what type of plot we are making. It's set to scatter right now, but press your right arrow button so we can select the second option that says XY line. So down, XY line, perfect. I'll hit enter. All right, looking good. The next option is what type of symbol we'll use on those individual data points. It's set to box. You can use a variety of other things. I'm just going to leave this one as box. Okay, now the most important. It wants to know where we'll be pulling all of this data from. Now, in that table, this first column was labeled as C1, and the second column was labeled as C2. So that's what I'm going to put into the calculator so it knows where it's pulling this data from. Let's see, there's C1 and C2, perfect. Leave the frequency and categories to no. And let's go ahead and press enter so we can save all of that plot information. All right, we're almost done. Now we just need to adjust our window so that we can see all of these data values. So let's go to window, it's right above F2, so green window. We want to adjust these values so that we can see everything on our year and everything on our enrollment. So I like to choose values just a little bit smaller and a little bit larger than the actual values we have. So the smallest year we have is 1990. So let's put our minimum year to be 1988, just a little bit before. Our maximum year is 2008. So a little bit larger than that. Let's do 2010. For the scale, notice how all of these years are going up by 2. So let's set the X scale to 2. This will ensure that every tick mark we see is a jump of 2 years. Okay, on to our Y values. Again, let's pick something smaller and larger than our actual data. All of the data over here, it looks like, well, they're all definitely over 1,000, but the largest one on here is 1,528. So let's set the minimum value to be 1,000, and the maximum value to be 1,600. Okay, that should be perfect. All right, and let's see, what shall we use for a scale? Let's go ahead and throw 100 in there. Okay, so now that our window is set, we already have our plots and our data is in there, now we can finally take a peek at this graph. Graph is right above your F3 key, so press the green arrow, graph, and now we have our actual line chart here. And it's looking pretty good. Let's go ahead and take a quick peek to see if it compares with our work by hand, see how accurate this is. Okay, so I'm seeing all of the same features that I did before. So we're getting this nice little peak here. I can see the valley, and we can see, looks like I should have done these a little bit steeper when I did it by hand. All right, so that's how you do a line chart into the 89 graphing calculator. If you want to see some individual data points as you're going through this, you can use your trace feature to walk through them one at a time. That's F3, and if you press that, you'll see it highlights the very first data point. So this first one is 1990, and it has the number of students 1,103. As you use the left and right arrow keys, it will walk through these individual data points. Okay, so now which one's highlighted? Looks like I'm on the year 2000, which has 1,271 students. And there you go. So now I can see all of my data as I walk through them. All right. If you'd like to see some more videos, please visit mysecretmathtutor.com.